Howdy folks, Jason and Carl here with kirkgiordano plastering, and today we're going to talk about fixing problem foundation areas of your stucco. Now, this is just a cosmetic repair. How many of you have issues where rats or bugs or things are getting underneath your stucco where the stucco and foundation are not butted up together perfectly? This is an 80-year-old building. All we're going to do today is fix this area so no more insects or rats are able to get in. Whatever your issues with your stucco or foundation, the process is usually very similar. We pulled back all of this dirt. We are going to clean the stucco with a really strong pressure washer. We're going to apply a bonding agent and probably hang some new mesh wire with concrete anchors, tapcons, so that our new stucco will adhere, and we're going to build this out to where it's true and plumb. So, to begin, you get your big powerful pressure washer, and we are cleaning the area very thoroughly underneath our key.
Today, I'm going to show you guys how we put something together. Now this, I looked at it, and the homeowner says, any idea how this happened? They just bought the house. I said, oh yeah, I know how that happened. That was a tree. And she said, what do you mean, a tree? I said, well, you see that tree right there? That's like 200 feet tall, maybe 50 tons, maybe 80, 100 tons. I said, you had one right here. And she says, now how do you know that? I said, because I could see the roots. I know all about these roots. Redwood trees, guys, you don't want them too close to the house. That one's like, that's pretty far from the house. But check this out. Okay. I don't know if you can see this, but this is a root. That's a root, guys. Now, Jay, they pressure washed this already. And all this blue stuff, that's just a bonding agent for these. And while I'm talking, I told Jay, oh, crap. Mix me up some really, really stiff mud because I want to do a scratch coat. And a scratch coat is just to put on all this wire in here, put every which way, is just for kind of looks. It's to hold this mud here so that, woo-wee, that's stiff. Hopefully I will be able to spread all this before them buckets get too hard on me.
Carl, the scoop for you.
Yeah. Ooh, yeah.
Come scoop.
Come scoop for me. And this texture here, guys, you probably already can see this. That's my brother Lou. I'm kidding. Lou didn't texture that. Lou hog carries, but occasionally he'll plaster. When I saw this, I thought, hey, my brother already been here. He beat me to the punch. Thanks, Carl. That makes it a lot easier. And all I'm doing, guys, is I'm putting about six inches on. I've got a Jay mixed the whole wheelbarrow, and we're doing bucket at a time because we want a lot of accelerators in here. A lot of accelerators. This will give us our base. And it would be about 90 degrees right now, so that's working. 90 degrees will set this quick. A little bit more. One more. Cool beans. All right. So with a day like today where we got, we got a lot of heat and we got hot mud. That's working. We need this. We did a house not too long ago. And we did 6 inches back to back to back to back around the whole foundation. In fact, I'm going to put that into the description in case you guys want to watch how to do 6 inches. I'm actually doing 6 inches here, but what when I say we did 6 inches, we were doing a foundation. The foundation seen better days. And all I want to do, guys, I don't care if this falls. Give me the rest. Give it all to me. This can fall all over the place. That's okay. This is just a base coat. All I want this to do is to set. And this will set in about, it's going to set quick. In fact, that one's already set. So when you push it in, it springs it and goes boing, pops it right back out. No worries, no worries. We don't care about that. Now here, I've got a lot of play. So I'm just going to gently push it in here. All I want to do is give myself something to, for the next coat to adhere. I do this so often with these accelerators that I got them down. And again, these wires are just to hold it. When this is set, that's going to be extremely strong. And the people, they said, well, what do you recommend? I said, have you got other people out here? They say, yeah. I said, have you heard tear the whole wall down and put a new concrete foundation in it? And they said, yeah. I said, I take it you didn't like that idea. What happened to that guy? They said, we shot him. So they don't want to do that, guys, because there's always going to be somebody who's going to say, you know, Kirk, there's a better way to do that. That's tear the whole wall apart and start from scratch. A lot of people don't like to do that, guys, especially when they find out the cost. They'd rather do a simple cost like this. And all we're doing, guys, is we're filling this up. Jay and Carl, they went ahead and anchored all this in. Will this crack? Again, I answered that question because when all the roots here rot, and they will, then that dirt is going to settle. And when it settles, this is going to hairline crack. It's just like the 4 or 5 months of rain we had. I've not seen so many cracked concrete driveways, cracked walls. Everything is cracking because of all that rain. That's just expansion. So everything expands and settles and shrinks. Which we got left?
We got about 2 scoops left.
Cool beans. I'm just going to put that. I'm going to put this on, guys. And then we're going to take like 10-minute lunch. I'm not going to put no scratch lines in this because it's already setting. You see that, guys? Anybody want to know what kind of cement this is? Anybody care? It's a lime cement. Lime cement. Unlike Portland, well, it does have Portland in it. It will flex. So when this moves, and it will, it'll flex a little bit more. Will it stop it from hairlining it forever and ever? There's no product that can do that. Again, they'd be looking at tearing the whole wall down and rebuilding it. What's that cost? $25,000. They can get away with pennies compared to that with what we're doing right here. This will prevent rodents, stuff like that, from going in there. But it is not going to correct the damage that had been done. Anyway, that's it?
Yep.
Cool. I'll tell you about those redwood trees. I've seen redwood trees where the whole house is lifted, and not far from here, where I remember bidding them a number of years back, and I said, man, I can't help you. I can't do nothing with that because it's off the foundation. These roots they get that big. A tree like that size, it'll get that big. It'll lift a whole house. It'll lift brick walls. It'll lift everything. Anyway, as soon as we get this done, I'll show you how we match Lou's finish. For those who might ask the question, hey, what kind of mud are you using? 690 BMI, reinforced fibered mesh. What other material can you guys use? You could use Green Core by Quickcrete. It's got fine sand, and you can get it at Home Depot. You could, if you want a heavier finish, like heavy sand, that sets just as fast as this, if not faster, you can go Rapid Set. Rapid Set, they named it appropriately. It sets fast. It'll set 5 minutes if that's what you want. You think, wow, man, I'm fast and I can set it quick and get the Rapid Set. Moving on, because this is quite easy for me. I'll tell you a story about these tree roots. A long time ago, well, I got pulled over when I was about 15 for driving my brother's car. I didn't have a license. And I went to see the judge because I thought it wasn't right to fine. It was like $150. But 50 years ago, man, that was a lot of money. Instead, the judge said, boy, you can't afford it, all right. 20 hours to work for the city. And I was adding it up in my head, and I thought, man, that's like 3 days work. And I objected, 40 hours work. And I thought, oh, man. Anyway, make a long story short, I had to go work for the city, and where I ended up working for was Castro Valley Community Center. And they had a big old redwood tree in the parks department, right in the front. And Eric was the supervisor. He had told me, Kirk, you're a pretty good worker. I better not say that. Anyway, he said, you're a pretty good worker. What I want you to do is, I want you to cut all those branches or limbs for the, it was a redwood tree like that, and all the roots grow on top. So anybody familiar with Castro Valley Community Center, the roots were all over the top, and he gave me a 3-foot axe, a triple axe it's called. So I had this triple axe, and I was doing this all day and got so bored. I was 15 years old. So I remember, I'm looking at the mud while I'm talking, thinking, you got enough, is this just right before so you don't lose that mud while you're getting carried away with a goofy story? Anyway, I was so tired of cutting roots that I started throwing this axe at the tree. And the first time I did it, it stuck. The axe stuck in the tree, a triple axe. That's a long-handled axe. And I thought, whoa, that is so cool. And I kept doing it. 15 years old. I remember old Eric, he came by, looked at it, says, oh my God, what happened to the tree? I said, oh crap. And I looked at the tree myself. It had like 200 marks where the bark came off where I was kept throwing that triple axe. That's how bored I was when I was 15. I wasn't even thinking about, man, you're damaging property. Anyway, it just reminds me of that time when I look at that tree right there. I shouldn't be telling people that goofy story, but I talk about a whole bunch of useless stuff when I'm bored. Anyway, we got almost enough. And here's another thing you guys can do too, because this mud right here, I'm gonna need a little bit more. This gotta set 10 more minutes. How do I know? Because I'm an expert. I do this for a living, guys. Say like this big blowout right here. Hit that. And you just put a texture on it. That's my loo texture. This right here, shave it off. Shave it off and pretty it up a little bit. Anyway, we're gonna give this a couple more minutes because I need 10 minutes there. Then we'll texture this and I'll show you guys how we do that too. We'll show you how to put a soupy texture on this. And if nothing else, you guys, if you got a buddy who just bought a house, or your mom, your dad, cousin, and you see him planting a redwood tree next to the house, tell him don't do that. A redwood tree should be like 80 feet from the house, because when it grows, that's probably 80 years old, it will tear your house up. Anyway, so what I did now, guys, to reinforce this and get a little bit stronger, we take a little bit of water. Always use water, guys. Bring it upward, upward, upward. Get that stuff going upward. That way, if it wants to fall, we're pulling it up. It sets with the water and it dries hard. Now what I did is we had that very stiff mud. I took some of the water here, put it in here, mixed it up, and let's see. I guess I can use this. Let's find out. That texture right there is a soupy texture. That just means a lot of water. I take that same mud that I was using, guys, same stuff, and soup it up. Now, I can look at this. That's got 20, 30 coats of paint on it. So we're going to try to match that. And all that is a blob job, guys. Just a blob. Come on now. Come on now. We want it to fall. We want it to drip. We want it to drip down. So a lot of excess mud. And what we can do is, if this is too blobby, we just go back over it with a sponge float. This right here. So let's see, maybe one or two more hockfuls and we'll have this licked. And after everything is put on, guys, then you look at it and see if you want to knock things down. Go every which way too. And go that way. One thing about when you make soupy mud, it gets all over the place. Okay, get stuff out of there. I told Jay, well, if this falls like it could, we just put it right back up. So I've been getting a lot of people saying, hey, Kirk, how do you make it stick? It doesn't want to stick. Make it richer, guys. Rich. If it won't stick, that means you got too much sand in it. So don't be afraid to use a little bit more stucco. On the YouTube channel lately, I've got so many people say, how do you make it adhere? It doesn't want to adhere. Make it richer, guys. Make it a little bit richer, and it will adhere. And don't forget the bonding agent if you're going over a painted surface. Now that's a little slobbery for this, so just look at it. Just take a trowel and go sideways. Just the idea is you get as close as you can to matching what this started off with. Okay, all right, and keep my foot in here. Yep. All right, so let's see. That's about it, guys. We have a lot more work we're doing, but Jay said, well, let's show this piece on how to do this. Just in case, there's a lot of reasons to do this, guys. Foundation falling apart, trees lifting it, car hits your house, a million reasons to do this. It's effective, strong as crap, or strong as cement stucco. Anyway, my name is Kirk, Jason Carl, hanging out around here. Lou Mixon, hope you didn't hear all that stuff. Anyway, my name is Kirk. We'll see you guys on the next one.
All right, folks, we want to thank you all for watching. If you enjoy the videos that we put out, please like and subscribe so that we can keep making these videos for everybody. And as always, from the entire Giordano family, we'll see you on the next one.